Hello everyone, and welcome back to Fly by Mars channel. Today we are going to review how to start the Airbus A320 from cold and dark condition. But what does it mean, cold and dark? This term to tell us that the aircraft is at parking stand, not electrical supplied. Before to go inside the cockpit, don't forget to perform the safety exterior inspection in order to be sure that the aircraft and the surrounding are ready for our operation. First of all, we need to cross-check if the chocks are in place. If the chocks are not in position, the crew must set the parking brake on and be sure that there is enough accumulator pressure. Be sure that the landing gear door are closed, and please don't pressurize any hydraulic system without the clearance from the ground staff. As final check, we need to observe if the APU inlet and outlet area are clear. Let's start now the preliminary cockpit preparation to ensure that all systems are ready before to apply the electrical system. Let's start from engine master 1 and engine master 2 switch off, engine mode selector normal, weather radar off, predicting wind shear off, gain auto, mode selectors auto. Landing gear down, wipers off. Battery 1 and 2 switches off, check the voltage above 25.5 and battery 1 and 2 switches auto. But what happens if the voltage is below 25.5 and why we must do this check? Basically, we must be ensured that the voltage is above 25.5 in order to be sure that we can start the APU just with the use of the battery. If the voltage is below this value, we must do a battery recycle charge. It will take around 20 minutes with the use of an external power. If the external power is available, external push button on. What does it mean, the green available light on the external push button? If the available light is the display, it means that the external power supply is connected to the system and all parameters are checked normal. Pressing the button, we are going to replace the available light with the blue on light. So now the external power is connected, or if the battery voltage is above 25.5, we can start the APU. Before to start the APU, we must perform the APU fire test. So we must check that push button is in and guarded, engine light are off, and the APU fire test push and maintain. APU fire test result is good if we have the APU fire warning on the ECAM, continuous repetitive chime, master warning light on, APU 5 push button switch LED in the red, squib light and discharge light on. APU master switch on, wait at least 3 seconds, APU start push button on. When the APU is available, APU bleed the push button on, all white lights off, cross bleed selector auto, and zone temperature selectors are required. Cargo heat temperature selector as desired. Now is the time for the flight crew to perform the exterior walkaround, but when and why? Basically, the flight crew must perform an exterior walkaround before each flight. The exterior walkaround ensures that the aircraft, the component, the equipment are ready for the flight and satisfactory. During the walkaround, the flight crew must check that there is no impact damage on the aircraft, there is no fuel, oil or hydraulic leak, and all the ground access doors are closed. Before to perform the walkaround, confirm the parking brake is set to on in order to check that wear indicator light is working properly.
On the door system display page, check the oxygen pressure. On the hydraulic system page, the reservoir fuel level checking the normal range. In the engine system display page, engine oil quantity normal.
check the flap position. On the upper you can display, we check the position of the flap. We check the speed brake, retracted.
And disarm it.
Accumulator pressure in the green arc. Working back on. Brake pressure. So from now on, we need to start to cross-check all the switches from the overhead panel, the central instrument panel, and the pedal stall. Basically, the philosophy is to have all the lights off, so it's dark, and the procedure will be basically from the bottom to the top in the D3 line, starting from the left, center, and right. Then we need to cross-check the central instrument panel, performing like an U. And then on the pedal stall, we need to cross-check the left, central, and right.
Ground control on,
loudspeaker
off,
interphone in int, int selector out and release and minimum volume.
Cockpit voice recorder test.
Just for your information, there are two types of devices for the cockpit voice recorder. One just record the last 30 minutes, the other one recorder 120 minutes. How can the flight crew must identify which devices are installed in the plane? Basically, depending on the result of the test. If the test has, like in this case, only one single tone, basically the devices may record 30 minutes. If the test has as result a short tone and one beep every 4 seconds, the devices may record 120 minutes.
Captain and captain or pulse switch on captain or as required by the company. All the IR switch on NAV. Number one, check on battery. Number two, check on battery light. Number three, check on battery light.
Setting the selector to NAV, we are realigned or aligned the IRs. There are two ways, one is a fast, one is a full alignment. Basically, we must perform a full alignment if there is a flight crew change or if this one is the first flight of the day. And then we need to perform a full alignment if the GPS is not available and the navigate coverage during the route are poor, or the GPS is not available and the flight time is more than 3 hours. And fast alignment must be performed if a full alignment is not necessary and the difference between the IR's position and GPS position is at or above 5 nautical miles. The flight crew must remember that we cannot perform any alignment during the engine start or if the engine are running. And if during the alignment we have any movement of the aircraft, we must perform a new full alignment.
The exterior lights, check the strobe is auto, beacon off, nav logo on, all other lights are off, sign on, no smoking auto, emergency exterior lights are. Probe window heat confirm in auto position, and cabin pressure landing elevation in auto position. On the air condition panel, we are checking the pack flow switch in the as required position.
So what does it mean, pack flux selector as required? Basically, the pack flux selector has 3 positions, low, normal, or high. If the total occupants of the aircraft is below 141 passengers, the selector can be set on low. if the outside condition has high humidity or hot, high hot temperature, so the selector can be set to high. If we have all other conditions, the selector can be set to normal.
On the electrical control panel, we confirm that no amber lights are displayed except generator 1 and generator 2 for light. We select the battery push button 1 and battery push button 2 on off and then on. Electrical push button, the ECAM control panel press on the electrical system display page. We cross-check that the current charge is below 60 ampere. In the fuel panel, we cross-check that all the lights are off. If in the center tank we have less than 200 kg, most selector manual, center tank pump 1 and center tank pump 2 off. Otherwise, we keep on. So now we check the engine fire test. So before to perform the test, we cross check the engine 1 push button switch is in, is it guarded, the agent light 1 and 2 off for engine number 1 and engine number 2, and then we perform the engine 1 test. And the engine 2 test. In the ventilation panel, we cross-check that all lights are off. In the audio control panel 3, the PA must be out. In the center instrument panel, we cross-check the ISIS, the clock, and anti-skid and no wheel steering in on position.
On the pedestal, we cross-check the audio control panel is set.
VHF knob 1 and 2 are on. Cockpit door switch in normal. Switching panel all are in normal. Thrust lever are idle. Engine 1 and engine 2 master switch off. Engine mode selector normal. Parking brake on. Emergency gravity extension lever retracted. ATC set. Auto, number 1 or number 2, on, above, standby. Now we can start to prepare the FMGC.
Finally, we are now ready to start the engine. All the systems are ready and set. Before to start the engine, don't forget to perform the before pushback and start checklist and to disconnect the external power. Before to request to disconnect external power, we must switch the external power switch button in order to have available lights display. In this way, we are sure that the ground staff will don't receive any injury to do the procedure. Let's start the engine. Engine number 2 and engine number 1. Ignition on. Engine number 2. When the engine number 2 is started, we can proceed with the starting engine number 1. So I hope that you enjoy watching. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, thumb up, and see you next time on the Fly by Mark channel.